is our next repair. This is a DAYMAK. It's one of the club members. It needs a little bit of work. We got a bulb floating around in there, but yet there's one there. So they likely dropped it in there. We'll fix this. It doesn't power up, so we're going to pull the back end off of it and go over the wiring from the ignition all the way to the back, and then test it. Hopefully it's something serious and you can have it back. We're into some of the guts before I get right into pulling it apart. This is one thing you don't want to see on the e-bike, is melted connectors on the phase wires, because what happens is if these two touch together when it's in motion, it'll blow a phase in the controller. So we'll have to pull it apart and definitely test that control. Okay, we're testing the motor. The controller has been removed, and here we go. Hulls are good, phases are good. Okay, now we're going to do a quick test of the controller. We're going to see if we get a standard 5 volts or standby. Just bypassing all the wiring in the bike. And there's your 5 volts. So the controller is functioning. So we're going to have to go through the wiring on the bike. It's been spliced and diced about a zillion times. So see what we... As you can see, the controller has sustained some damage. The cap is blown. The chip still works, but the fets are blown. And as you can see, it used the shunt as a fuse, which they do on these cheaper bikes. I'm going to try and wire up a another model and see if that'll work, but this controller is toast. Okay, this is with my test controller. We've got power. And everything is working here. Starting signals. This light on this side is out. The ones on the front, all working. Okay, check out.